Hello everyone, let's start today's class. We were doing the back exercise of chapter 1, Monday Morning Blues. Yesterday we have done A3, A4, A5. Part was done in the English Reader Notebook, and A6 is the life skill that we will discuss when the school will get reopened. And A7 we have already done yesterday. Now today I am going to start with part A. 8. The question of A8 is, Aunt Polly told Tom, "You always break my heart." The word break can be used in many ways when it is succeeded by words like up, down, into, out, etc. The word succeeded means comes after. The meaning of the first word gets changed. Here the first word is break. When this word is succeeded by down, into, out, up, upon, these are called phrases. So now I am going to tell you the meaning of these phrases. The first is breakdown, means to stop working. Break into, to enter forcibly. Breakout means spread. It may be the spread of a disease. Break up means to separate. And break open means forcibly open. Means if you open something by applying your force. Now we will use these phrases in the given blanks. The first one is, on his way to the office, Mr. Paul Carr dash, there was no one to help him. The answer is broke down. And the meaning of the breakdown was to stop working. The second is, the robbers dashed the safe and escaped with a lot of money. The answer is broke open, means forcibly open. The third is, let's dash for lunch. We will meet again after an hour at the same place, the principal announced. The answer is breakup, means to separate or to disperse. Next is, the thieves dashed the house at night when everyone was fast asleep. The answer is broke into, means to enter forcibly. The last one is, the municipal corporation swung into action when they heard that malaria had dashed in the city, means broke out. Broke out means spread of a disease. Here the disease is malaria. So now A9 part, and some of pair of words look so similar that they get confused with each other. These are called homophones, and four such pairs are given below. I'm going to tell you the meaning of each and every word. The first pair is lay and laid. The meaning of lay is to put something down. Laid means to relax. Next pair is farther and further. Farther means a great distance. Further means to a more advanced stage. The third pair is loss and lose. The answer of loss is no longer have. The answer of lose is not fixed, not tightly fixed. The last pair is heel, H-E-E-L, and heel, H-E-A-L. The meaning of first is the back part of the foot. And the meaning of second is to become healthy again. Now, you know the meaning of all these words. Now, we will fill up these blanks. The first one is, the wound took a long time to heal. Which heal? H-E-A-L. The meaning of this heal is to become healthy again. The next is, I think this point needs dash discussion. The answer is further. Spelling is F-U-R-T-H-E-R. The meaning of this is to a more advanced stage. Next, the mother gently dashed the baby on the grass. The answer is laid. L-A-I-D. Laid means to relax. The last one is, where did you dash that beautiful pen of yours? The answer is loss. L-O-S-E means no longer have. So today we have done A8 and A9 part of the back exercise from your English Reader book. These parts are on page number 7 and page number 8. Now homework for you. Do this in your English reader book. And you, if you are not having your reader books with you, do it in your rough notebook and mention the question number properly, like A3, A4, A7 and A8. That's all for today. Thank you.